Here, we are going to solve a minimization problem using geometry instead of calculus. The problem goes something like this, that may be inspired by the Pentagon, headquarters of the US Department of Defense. The Department of Mathematics decided to build their own headquarters called the Triangle. As the name suggests, the Triangle had three wings, and between them, they had a nice lawn. And to access it, they had provided gates, one for each wing. So here is one gate, the other gate, and the third gate here. And these three gates were connected by a walkway. Now they decided to minimize the length of this walkway so that the mathematicians don't waste time walking between the buildings, but inside the buildings inventing something. So in its abstract form, the problem reduces to, given a triangle, that is this lawn, find another triangle inscribed in it, that is the walkway, so that its perimeter is the minimum. This problem was first proposed and solved by Fagnano, in its abstract form of course, and he used calculus, but we'll be using geometry. So let's get started using this arbitrary scalene triangle, say PQR, representing the building, and we have to find this walkway whose length is to be minimized. For doing that, we'll use an entity from physics which is known to follow the shortest possible path. And this is known as Fermat's principle, which says light always follows the quickest path possible. So if we keep a source of light at the right position, the gate here, and shine it in the right direction, the gate here, then the light will form a loop like this, which will be of minimum perimeter. But how to make light take turns like this? Well, we can use reflection. So if we fit mirrors PQ, QR and RP, then a beam of light will be forming a loop like this. Of course, for that we'll have to have these three points figured out just the right way. And for reflection, we know one fact, and that is the incident ray and the reflected ray make equal angles with the mirror. So instead of these walkways, we can now think in terms of these rays. Now, if we label these angles as say alpha, beta and gamma, then we can find the angles inside this triangle as 180 minus 2 alpha, 180 minus 2 beta and 180 minus 2 gamma. So they must add up to 180, giving us a relation between alpha, beta, gamma as their sum is equal to 180. And that dictates this angle at the vertex P must be equal to this gamma. Let us name these points of incidences or the position of gates as say A, B and C, and we will treat this entire diagram as an object which is to be reflected about this mirror PQ. So when we take this kind of reflection, we will get the triangle P dash, Q dash, R dash, the image. Then we'll observe something interesting here. These two angles are already known to be equal. But even this angle must be equal to this angle because it is just a reflection of it. And that makes these two angles looking like the vertically opposite angles equal. And for vertically opposite angles to be equal, we must have intersection of two straight lines. PQ is a straight line already, but what it is telling us is this path C, B, B dash, A dash is also a straight line. In other words, our incident ray continues straight in the same direction into the mirror. And this will happen once again if we take one more reflection. Again, about this line PR dash. So here, incident ray will simply continue from C to B, then from B dash to A dash, and then to A double dash, C double dash. So from this point C to the image of its image, C double dash, light is going to go straight. And this is in accordance with Fermat's principle as well. Now if we form this triangle, say C double dash PC, which I have reproduced here for clarity, we'll make some observations. This angle P must be equal to 2 times this vertex angle, because what we have done is essentially taken this triangle and reproduced it twice. So let's mark that angle. And this angle we showed to be equal to this angle, which we called as gamma. So if this is gamma and this is gamma, this must be 2 times gamma. This PC double dash is an image of an image of this line PC. So there is no reason why it should be different. So these two lengths must be equal, making the triangle an isosceles triangle, and that will let us figure these angles here. These angles must be, say, 180 minus 2 gamma divided into two parts. So 180 minus 2 gamma upon 2 giving us 90 minus gamma, or gamma complement. So this is the complement of this angle. So if here you have an angle gamma and a complement of it, together they will form a 90 degree angle, making this line PC perpendicular to our base RQ. So this is nothing but the altitude of this triangle, and our gate C is located at the foot of that altitude. So that is the trick of locating the gate. The gate is at the foot of the perpendicular. Similarly, this gates B and C will also be located at the feet of these. And then our pathway is simply a triangle that connects these 3 feet of altitudes. Such a triangle is called as an orthic triangle. And that is the solution of our minimization problem. Given a triangle like this, we first draw 3 altitudes and simply join the feet of these altitudes, giving us the minimum perimeter inscribed triangle.